What are three ways to light up somebody's brain like a Christmas tree? This can be useful in goal setting. This can be useful in motivating someone. This can be useful in really experiencing the world in a more positive way, to switch emotions, to feel more resourceful, etc. So, tip number one. Well, in NLP, we teach the difference between association and dissociation. When you think of a memory or a representation in your mind in any way, then you have two ways of seeing that. You can either see yourself over there, which means that the emotions are over there, though that's useful for reality testing and learning from a more scientific neutral observation. It's not really useful to light up the brain. We light up the brain by associating. So we, in essence, we see this memory or this representation or this thing in the future, like reaching a goal. And it's about what we see, hear, and feel at that moment in time. So looking at it through our own eyes. Which leads me to tip number two. Tip number two is really understand that if you want to light up the brain, you not only do so associated, but you need to do that, as we say in NLP, four-tupled. And four-tupled is the way that an epic movie works or an epic book is written. It's a way to light up the imagination, to light up something that is experienced in the brain is real, even though it's not happening right now. And that is by focusing on what you would see, hear, feel, smell slash taste. And the reason why I say smell slash taste is because taste and smell are very closely linked inside the brain. So that's why it's a four-tuple and not a five-tuple. So you want to make sure that you light that up. Third thing I'd like to say in that is what we call submodalities. And submodalities are a subset of the modalities, and modalities are just a more complicated word for our senses. So seeing, hearing, feeling, smelling, tasting. So the subset of the modalities would be something, let's say in the visual system, it would be size, how big it is in your mind. It could be brightness or color or black and white or panoramic or more focused, transparency, blurry, all those different things are subsets. Now, when you think about it, the auditory system has these subsets as well. Think about volume. Think about the direction or surround sound or pitch or speed. In a kinesthetic system, we have it as well, where you could think about things like breathing, where are you breathing from? Any experiences inside your body, a sense of being a weight on your shoulder, being outside of your body. So when you're coaching someone or when you're coaching yourself, is how can you enhance those submodalities by making it bigger, by making it brighter, by bringing it closer, by making it more focused, by making it louder, though not uncomfortably loud, by making the sound more intense in both ears, surround sound, by having the right breathing from the location to the space to regularity, by sort of like creating an energy force inside the body, by creating an energy force around the body. Think about if you're into chakras, what you could do with the chakras. If you're into breath work, what could you do with breath work? If you're into mindfulness meditation, how can you incorporate those things to intensify and to light up the brain?